pop, 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 pop. I'm like, okay, that was weird. Like, I just broke his foot, but he's still fighting. Immediately, we're starting the match. Gantumur is staying close to the cage, so he kept pushing my head against the wall, which is a very good strategy. I immediately start attacking a triangle maplata, and I end up in a K-guard sequence. So basically, what I'm doing when I play K-guard, I'm looking at Gantumur's knee, his left knee. If his knee is in versus out. If I'm able to keep his knee in, I begin attacking leg lock.
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, that looks very painful.
I'm holding his foot, and now I place his foot on my neck, okay? Which I call the Mikey lock. It's the same mechanics as a heel hook in your armpit, but I'm using my neck as a pit to do it.
Yeah, that looks like that thing is out.
Man, I am cringing watching this, man.
Pop, 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 pop. I'm like, okay, that was weird. Like, I just broke his foot, but he's still fighting. Now I'm like, okay, let's go to an inside heel hook, which is in the armpit. So this is, like, checkmate. Like, now I'm starting to feel his knee start breaking. You know when you rip cardboard, it feels identical to that. And I'm getting nauseous again. Thank you guys for making me do this. I feel his leg breaking, but his face has no expression. So it's confusing. It's like, how the hell is this guy just taking this, you know? So I have the reverse figure four grip, and now we turn. So now my pelvis here is bridging into his knee, and the heel is coming up. I kind of became psychotic. I felt like I had an axe, and I was like cutting a tree. But I realized I'm doing that on somebody's leg.
We were speaking earlier about how tough Mongolians were, and this is just a true testament of that.
I feel like this belly down is the worst spot for him, where I can feel like everything breaking. So I realized, like, a minute and 40 seconds, like, okay, he's not gonna tap, so I'm just gonna switch to something else. I let go of the heel hook, and I'm like, oh, screw it. I come up, and I start passing. And here I get a good, nice pass. I get a guillotine grip. When you have a guillotine, they can push you against the cage, which affects your leverage to actually finish the guillotine. Now I go K-guard again on the other leg now. Look how his knee came out. So his knee is out now, right? What does that mean? We're gonna take the back. And now I'm just gonna lock my hands like a body lock and put pressure like a cast slice, hamstring stretch. And now I'm on his neck. And now there's 46 seconds left. I knew he wouldn't tap to this though. There's no way after those crazy heel hooks, he just taps to a calf slicer. Like, imagine. I clear his knee, and now I'm on his back. Looking back, I wish I would've just did this from, like, the first minute, so then I didn't injure him. If I do a choke, I don't have to deal with anything. The fight ends, like, it's nice. Props to him for eating a full heel hook, you know? It didn't change the result of the match, so what was the point of me just completely tearing his knee, right? And I was kind of angry at him, because I was like, why did he make me do this? I think that showed everyone in the crowd how dangerous it could be. It's a violent sport. The person doesn't tap, you break everything. And I think that's why this fight was so good for the jiu-jitsu community. Not good for Gantumur's knee, and I feel horrible about that.